Each year, a potentially dangerous active volcano within the nation of Colombia emits a little over 400 pounds of gold. While this might sound like a tall tale told by a 16th century Spanish conquistador, as certain conquistadors actually attempted to retrieve reported gold from the lava lake of Nicaragua's Masaya volcano in 1538, the reports regarding the Colombian volcano of Galeras are actually true. As, due to a combination of geologic phenomena, this active volcano, which last erupted in 2014, produces a stunning amount of gold worth approximately $11.3 million each year. This gold is all ejected from a single, fairly narrow source, Galeras' 305-meter or 1,000-foot-wide active crater. This gold is ejected every day primarily as a mixture of microscopic particles and molecules of gold in a gas phase within the typically white-colored volcanic gas plume, rising high into the atmosphere to be eventually dispersed over a wide area. Yet, not all of this gold is lost into the atmosphere, as every day, 56 of the 510 grams of gold which is emitted instead sublimates as native gold, electrum aka gold which contains 30% to 45% by weight silver, and as microscopic crystals within the wall rocks of the volcanic crater. But there is more. The highly altered andesite lava rocks, which primarily compose Galeras' summit region, contains a potentially economic concentration of gold, as these lava rocks contain 15 grams of gold per metric ton of ore. While this might not sound like a lot, this is such a high grade that many mining company execs could only dream of, as some existing gold mines turn a profit despite only producing as little as 0.6 grams per metric ton of ore. Alongside producing approximately 510 grams of gold each day, Galeras seemingly also produces 3.6 kilograms of copper and potentially more than a kilogram of silver every day through the same manner. So, should people or companies be rushing to mine this ore, whose existence has been known by scientists since at least 1994? To this I say no, with several good reasons. First of all, the Galeras volcano is completely located within a national park, so collecting there is always illegal. And even if it was allowed, which it isn't, it would be too dangerous to attempt to extract any ore rock, as not only can lethal levels of deadly volcanic gases which are heavier than air such as carbon dioxide pool in Galeras' bowl-shaped crater, but this volcano's eruptions are sometimes impossible to predict in the first place, so there might be no warning if it was about to erupt. But what about the 89% of gold, silver, and copper ore which escapes into the atmosphere? If Galeras was hypothetically not a protected area where mining was forbidden, and it was hypothetically known that it was not going to erupt for the next several thousand years, could the gas phase metals be extracted? The answer to this is surprisingly yes. At Russia's Kudriavy volcano in the Kuril Islands, its active crater via a series of high-temperature fumaroles releases 20 metric tons each year of an element twice as rare as gold, the element rhenium. For more than two decades, there has been attempts to extract quantities of this element, as such production could end up representing 49% of world rhenium production, potentially being worth $32.2 million. The plan was to build a giant concrete dome which would separate various gases by density before sending the dense rhenium gas into a secondary trap containing numerous zeolites. Using a smaller scale of this methodology, reportedly 17 kilograms of rhenium was extracted during a test in 2016. Thus, in perfect conditions, a similar setup could be used to capture the gold at Galeras. Yet, why does so much gold exist at this volcano in the first place? The answer is that Galeras' active crater and the underlying magma conduit which supplied it were not always in the same location. Thus, over hundreds of thousands of years preceding the present, heated hydrothermal fluids rose above its 2-kilometer-deep magma chamber, rising along with various volcanic gases and concentrations of valuable elements such as copper and gold, which were then deposited along highly altered rock, forming what is known as an epithermal deposit. In recent times, the magma conduit simply cut through the existing ore body, so that now every day parts of it are boiled and fragmented into small particles, subsequently being ejected via volcanic gas plume. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.